The Indians. The name's been around more than 100 years in Cleveland. Parting with it won't be easy.
We're never trying to be disrespectful.
No, but the team has been under mounting pressure to recognize it is disrespectful. It comes 2 years after the Indians dropped the offensive Chief Wahoo mascot. In a statement, team owner Paul Dolan acknowledges the name has detrimental effects on Native American people, the club adding, "We can unify our community and bring people together with a new name." Philip Yenyo confronted Cleveland fans for years.
It feels really good that steps are being taken, that our voices are being heard.
It's taken decades for many U.S. colleges to abandon Indian-based nicknames and offensive mascots. In Canada, McGill University only dropped the term Redmen from men's varsity teams a year ago. They're now the Redbirds. But pro sports teams have been especially slow, with enormous investments in their iconic symbols.
No peace!
This past summer, however, protests against systemic racism brought new demands to drop such imagery once and for all. The Washington Redskins finally gave in after sponsors threatened to walk out. They're managing this season without a nickname. The Edmonton Eskimos are also looking for a new team name. And now, so is Cleveland's baseball team. Except not for another year, to give them time to switch to a new name and perhaps move some merchandise while they can. Some say it's a mistake to delay.
Once you say you're not going to use it anymore, you can't use it anymore, or else you're sort of defeating the purpose of changing it.
Still, the name will go, and that's the important thing, says one baseball writer.
It's not a popular decision in Cleveland, but it had to be made.
Several other sports teams still have controversial names, and the question is, who might be next to change? Eric Sorensen, Global News, Toronto.